Good morning and welcome to Cook for Fun TV. Today is Sunday, September 24th, 2017, and the time is approximately 9:23 in the Eastern Standard Time Zone, and we're broadcasting to you live from the Greater Toronto Area of Ontario, Canada. And today's menu is two ketone items, as in foods that are accommodating to those on the ketogenic diet or a low-carb diet with high protein and lots of vegetables. And we are making pizza zucchini muffin and pad thai tofu. So let's get started. And hello to Kent0456 and Merbear Lorelei. Thanks for being our first viewers. I did note your messages in the chat and apologize for making you wait. I do hope you enjoy this stream. We are featuring a few tips that will hopefully improve your presentation using spring onions, and also in learning how to work with a tamarind paste. So thank you again for being our early viewers. And I noticed a comment about the ketone, getting ketoned in here by Merbear Lorelei. And if you're newly tuned into our channel, I think you've been watching for the last couple of streams. Mr. Cook for Fun is on a ketone diet since approximately 2 months now, which is pretty good. And every now and then we will throw in a ketone recipe so that we can ensure that he can eat as well. And I think there's also general interest too in the community for health or lowering carbohydrates. We get quite a bit of viewers who mention that they are cutting down or they're not eating as much of certain foods. So we're keeping this, we're mixing this up a bit. And it's our first time trying any of these, so hope you'll get to hear the assessment once we sample at the end of the show. But I generally have good luck with the recipes because they've been reviewed by the online community, and we'll just see how it goes. Merbear, so it rhymes. That makes sense. So it's not mermaid, it's merbear. Merbear, okay, versus merbear, okay, merbear. All right, and exclamation mark recipe will get you the recipes, the recipe that we are using for today's stream. Okay, I'm gonna grab our box grater and we'll get ready to start. We're actually doubling this recipe today. The recipe yields 6 muffins. I'm gonna take the chance that this recipe is gonna turn out all right and double it so that we have extra to freeze for the week. So we are proponents of cooking for a week as well. Mr. Cook for Fun made a really large pot of pasta sauce yesterday using homegrown tomatoes. We harvested quite a bit over the weekend, around 2 basins full of tomatoes, and he decided to make them all. So in order to keep it for the week, we're going to freeze it. We have them in separate containers. Yeah. And I wanted to read the recipe to you as well so that you can have a sense of how we're going forward with this. So the recipe calls for one medium zucchini. We're doubling it, so if we were to rewind this, the zucchini was a lot bigger, around this long, also homegrown, and part of it was used yesterday to make zoodles for the pasta sauce that Mr. Cook for Fun made yesterday, and there was still a lot left, so we're using the rest of the zucchini for today's muffin recipe, and I'm just going to approximate that the leftover is approximately two medium zucchinis for this doubled version of the recipe. And a lot of ketone recipes use zucchini as a flour substitute. So we also featured a few streams ago zucchini chocolate cake, which is actually a common dish in Germany. But it's become more popular due to the ketone movement. People now know about this German chocolate cake dish that's made out of zucchini. So, Mare Bear's had the name misspelled many times. I get my real name misspelled too. Yeah. But it keeps it interesting. It becomes a conversational topic when you have to let people know. But I can see it going both ways. Like Mare Bear because it rhymes, or Mer Bear because people are thinking of mermaid, or just sounding out the M-E-R. Mare Bear. Mare Bear Lorelei. And that's very endearing when people put bear in their name. I know that. Like I've heard on TV, Claire Bear, or like name, and then with a bear at the end of it. It's very endearing. Yeah. I was actually going to consider using the food processor to shred all this zucchini, and I did that for our chocolate zucchini cake stream. But I thought it's really loud, and I can keep it easy by using a grater. I think more people own a grater than a processor, so we try to show that anything you make could be possible with common kitchen equipment and tools. And it was actually, as you can see, I zipped right through this. Like the zucchini is quite ripe, it's soft. Yeah, so that wasn't easy. Yes, I could prevent bloody fingers by being careful. Okay. Kendo456, I cooked diced cabbage, chicken, sausage, and egg in a pan with oil. Very nice. So that's like a little stir fry you made, and you can be creative with stir fry dishes in general, and just use ingredients that you like. So the diced cabbage, that's really nice. So if it's diced up, it's really fine and it cooks faster. Cabbage is a heartier vegetable, almost like a carrot, and it just needs a bit more time to get it soft to bite through rather than super crunchy as it is in its raw state. So part of it that I'm holding here is just a little bit spoiled. Oh, it's not sinking. That's so funny. It's not syncing the webcam. Okay, great. And so I promised to read out the ingredients so that you can understand. There's music in the background. Can you hear it? I have our Sonos system playing classical music. I figure it's probably not gonna get cut out of our video. Yeah. Well, I'm glad you think it sounds yummy. We shall see. Anything pizza though, I think is yummy. Even if it's bad pizza. I love all pizza. So having pizza in the name, it helps. And I missed a message from a new viewer. Yeah, hi. Oh, okay. Jessupy, how are you? Welcome back to our show. Yeah. Oh, thanks for your comment about seeing us live. I've had a podcast playing over the week, and it keeps the channel interesting because we only stream once a week, and otherwise we would have nothing playing. We also auto-host other Twitch chefs or cooks. Yeah, but I find that most of them stream around similar time over the weekend. So, yeah. And we have a greeting from Mr. Morla Hood. Salut as well to you. Okay. Okay, and just behind a bit. My name, it's a mystery. I've been given a name by one of our moderators, Marie. As in Marie with an accent aigu on the E. There is a Scottish Japanese singer from New York who's pretty big in Japan. Scottish Japanese singer, yeah, named Marie Digby. But yeah, that's the name I've been given. Yeah. So you can call me Cook for Fun, or Fun. Yeah, Fun is nice too. A short version of Cook for Fun. And, oh, you give bear hugs. That's very nice. I have met bear huggers, quite a few of them in my life. Yeah. Meeting for the first time, a big bear hug. It's always a great way to warm up any occasion. Yeah, we have a neighbor who has a young son, and my dad went out in the morning to do some lawn work, and then the little boy was out. I guess his father was nearby, but he was out, and he came up to my father and gave him a big bear hug. And my dad told me about it. That's so sweet. So, yeah, definitely an opening to new friendship that way. And we talk about this concept of friendship and food often on this stream, and how food is friendship, despite a language barriers that people might have, or people being strangers. Once you offer food to someone, you have a friend. And it's just symbolic of love and peace. So the bear hug thing definitely as well. Yeah. Okay, I am gonna leave these here, rinse my hands, and grab a spatula, spatula's good, or a spoon. I have both a wooden spoon and a spatula, and I'm going to just sort of mix this. Yeah, while I chat with you. Yeah. And I'm quite behind. Oh, you can hear the music. That's nice. Okay. I had it on a couple nights ago. My parents are on a trip. They went to Taiwan, and they're going to Guangzhou, China. They're joining a couple of tours, and their flight was late at night. It was like a midnight flight, like an overnight red eye flight. And I didn't like, everyone's always worried about packing last minute. So to ease them of the worry, I cooked them a simple dinner, like something that's, it was actually vegetarian, because I figure when they're traveling and eating with the tour, they're gonna, just eating out in general, they're going to load up on carbs and protein and like grease. So I made them pasta as well. Yeah. What else did I make? And some stir-fried kale. Yeah. Yeah. So I had the music on. It's just a radio station. I think it's called Classic Radio Pianos. Classic spelled like the C's are replaced with a K. K-L-I-S-S-I-K. Radio Pianos. So, and they liked it. The speakers are actually in the room next to here. It's playing in the TV room. And they just like that. It's sort of background music. It's not, you don't listen to it actively. It's just, yeah. So I want to try that out. So we'll see if it gets banned. I don't know. I hope not. Yeah. Oh, so all the computers are lagging. That used to happen in my earlier streams. I think it happens though in general. Like if you type a comment in, I won't see it until a few seconds after you've typed it. Yeah. Canadian potato internet, sorry. What's that referring to? Canadian potato internet, sorry. Classic was a gentle way to start the day. Most other streams right now on my follow list are pumping EDM right now, and I think it's a little time. I need a little time before I'm ready for that. So when I went out to my parents' place to harvest the green onion, hence why I was late for today's stream. Sorry for those who waited, Mayor Baron Kent. I left the music on, and when I came back, it was nice to walk into the home with this music playing. And it reminded me at that moment of the music you hear at spas.